Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Daniel Rosehill here. I want to record another video about the XA40 professional camcorder from Canon. And what I want to talk about today, I just got in the post very fortuitously before the end of the week, my first XLR shotgun microphone. And this is the Boya BYBM6060. Now the purpose of this video is if you've just picked up the XA40 and you're looking to buy a shotgun, I just want to tell you, or show rather, why you should probably go for a compact shotgun. They do exist. They're also known as short shotguns. So the first thing is, like, this camera is really, really small. So it's sometimes hard to judge by YouTube videos or product photos exactly how small this is. So you can see there from the bottom of the viewfinder to the with the lens on, or the lens hood on, that's 23 centimeters. And just getting to the lens, it's probably only actually 19 centimeters. For reference, here's my hand. I have a normal sized hand, I think. And, like, you know, it's so compact, I can literally hold it top handle to bottom with my hand. So Canon really don't exaggerate when they say that they've put the pro camcorder look, the top handle, etc., into a really small form factor. Now that's great for portability, but it does present a problem when you're buying microphones, because your standard shotgun microphone is built for either a boom or just a bigger, or if it's, you know, if it's to be used for on-camera stuff, it's just intended for a bigger camera. I mean, you can just see that is not right, right? That shotgun microphone is too long. So I did ask on Reddit for recommendations for compact XLR shotgun microphones. I did get a couple of recommendations. I will put those in the description. Please be aware, at least at the time I'm recording this, I'm not putting up affiliate links. I'm just kind of trying to help people in the right direction who are also interested in camcorders. So measuring my shotgun, this guy is 28. So that's actually longer than the camcorder. And that's not by any stretch a very, very long shotgun microphone. It's a little longer than some of the more expensive Sennheiser stuff. But I just want to show you guys two things. Firstly, here's just a little pro tip, as they call it. This shotgun mount that comes with the XA40 and 50, etc., it actually doesn't tighten very far. This is as tight as it'll go. So what I did, it wouldn't fit, this would not fit snugly. And what I did here, if you can make out the distinction, I wrapped around this in black insulation tape, black just, you know, so to keep the appearance looking good. And I had to go for quite a while until it would add enough width, or diameter, I should say, to the shotgun before it would fit snugly. So that's just a quick tip for you guys. And I'll just show you how this looks, because the reason I bought this $60 shotgun was because I've just spent, you know, a lot of money on the camera, and, you know, I'm going to save up a little bit before I can justify buying a $300 better compact short shotgun microphone. So I figured this will keep me going, and then afterwards I'll have it for, I guess, booming or something. So I just want to show you what it looks like. It's not the worst, but it's also not the best. So with the insulation tape, it does fit really snugly. You can see, you know, it's not going anywhere, which is good. But it definitely, just in proportion, it just looks wrong, I think. Bear in mind as well that by the time you attach your XLR cable, whereas the female, you're going to be adding, you know, another bit here. And that's, it just kind of, two things, it detracts from the portability of the camcorder. This actually fits in my existing camera bag, which is amazing because I didn't need to buy a new camera bag. But when you add the extra length from the this shotgun microphone, it doesn't fit. So that might be a concern for you. And yeah, it's just great to have something so portable, and then to throw a big chunky mic, I think is kind of dumb. So yeah, I definitely would recommend looking into portable options. It does work. One really, really small and pedantic point, but as this is kind of a pedantic point video, I'll say it nevertheless. This is the shortest XLR cable that I had in my camera bag. I don't know how long it is. I would guess approximately, maybe it's 60 centimeters end to end. Yeah, it's probably 60, but in any event, that's already way too long. You only need to go from the back of your microphone to the XLR port. And as I said in my last video, you want to use input one. So you're talking about, I mean, again, I'm using my hand here. You're talking about a span of only this much. It's really not that much ground to cover. So you should also probably buy, if your microphone doesn't come with an XLR cable, or even if it does, I would buy the shortest XLR that'll make that reach. I think 30 centimeters would do it, because they include the attachments in the length. You might even be able to get away with shorter, so you might need to buy a couple to experiment with. Anyway, I'm really happy to have a shotgun that I can now use with this, and I can guess the advantage of using this over a 3.5mm is that you have all your all the controls you might need on the hardware level. You have your phantom power switch, regular switch, line-in switch, automatic gain control, manual gain control, off-on switch. So versus using a 3.5mm or an eighth shotgun, which you can do, you can attach it in here. The advantage of using an XLR microphone is that if you're already using the top handle, it's already there. You can, it can fit into your shotgun mount, but more importantly that when you're out shooting and interviewing, instead of fiddling around with levels on the LCD screen here, you have access to all that at literally the touch of a button. So I think that's a worthwhile enough advantage to go with an XLR mic over a 3.5mm, even though this guy can technically support both. Hope that was useful if you're looking at buying a microphone for your XA40, a shotgun microphone. I'll put a link in this description to the microphones, the compact microphones that I found myself and with the help of Reddit, because there are a few on the market. They're definitely more expensive than this $60 Boya microphone. But yeah, if you have the money to go and buy one, and definitely I think it's probably better to get something that's sized more appropriately for this camera than a big long shotgun that's just gonna look a bit, little bit OTT or whatever. I hope this video is useful, and if you wanna get more videos from me on a whole bunch of different topics, please feel free to subscribe. Thanks for watching.